Welcome, my dear friends. Myself, Professor Dr. R.R.deshpande, would like to welcome you in this PPT video show. The title, Panchakarma in GP, that is Medical General Practice, Part 7. We are here nearly at the end of Swedana topic. Of course, in a very practical way, Swedana, that is a fomentation, Part D, presented by Professor Dr. R.R.deshpande, that is myself. You can communicate to me through 922-6810-630. This is my WhatsApp number as well. I am thankful to Dr. Sachin Sarpotdar and Dr. Mayura Jadhav and Shinde for the nice contribution or help to prepare this contents of this PPT to me. Purpose of the PPT is, of course, to boost the confidence in medical students in general and Ayurvedic and homeopathic students in specific, to boost the confidence in the medical practitioners who have started their practice very recently and they want very precise and practically oriented knowledge in a very simplified manner. But here we have to give some caution to the common man, because many times they are provoked by this information and they start to use this information of their own. This is not expected by these videos. This is not for self-medication. Of course, you can use this knowledge for in your life, but under the supervision or under the guidance of your family physician. Contents of this PPT, after the indications in this particular video, we are going to talk about contraindications. I am sorry, there is a printing mistake, contraindication of the Swedana or the fomentation. I am extremely sorry for deep TP mistake. Then procedure of Swedana or the fomentation. Then symptoms after the proper fomentation, that is optimal fomentation. By chance, if there is an error of, by chance it happens that excess fomentation is given, then what will happen, how you can recognize those symptoms, then management after excess fomentation, what we should follow and what we should do. All these things we are going to see in this short PPT video show. Now first we will begin with the contraindications for Swedana Karma. As this, all the Swedana procedures are having the substances or the procedure as such is heat provocating, sharp in nature, hot and light in nature. So we must understand the contraindications on the basis of these properties. Naturally, the Pitta Prakriti person who is already having the lot of heat inside the body, or Pitta Vata Prakriti person who is also having the light and the hot quality in his bodies, or the dry qualities in his bodies, undernourishment is there. So they should not go for Swedana Karma directly. Then Pitta dominated diseases, like for example jaundice, peptic ulcer, these are contraindications for Swedana Karma or fomentation. Pitta and Rakta. Ayurveda always say that Pitta bioenergy and Rakta or the blood tissue or the dhatu are having intimate correlation with each other. That means Pitta and Rakta, Pitta bioenergy is showing its function through the media of Rakta Dhatu. For example, metabolic process, heat regulation mechanism, all is controlled by Pitta but exhibited by the Rakta or the blood. So naturally, we have to take care of this Pitta bioenergy and Rakta Dhatu of the tissue when we are applying the Swedana Karma or fomentation. We must avoid the Swedana in bleeding disorders, for example, epistaxis, then hematemesis, then bleeding through the nose, bleeding through the mouth, bleeding through the ear, then retinal hemorrhage, hemoptysis, brain hemorrhage, subarachnoid hemorrhage, peptic ulcer, hematuria, bleeding through the urine, per rectal bleeding, which is called as a PR bleeding. If there is a heavy menstruation, periods are going on with the female. If there is a subconjunctival hemorrhage, bleeding gums. So in all these bleeding conditions, one must not advise, one must not take the Swedana Karma or the fomentation. Next category of contraindication, if there is a weakness, debility, exhaustion due to the heavy physical or mental work, or it may be weakness may be due to the chronic degenerative physical diseases like, for example, cancer, HIV or the AIDS, it may be the tuberculosis, then it may be the blood cancer. One must very, very caution, or there must be experts' suggestion, advice, guidance, observation before giving Swedana Karma. Even we must avoid Swedana, strong Swedana in very fat person or very thin person. Now there may be doubt that in previous session you are telling that obese person should receive the fomentation. Here I am saying very fat person should avoid the fomentation. What is correct? Correct is this, that these very fat and very thin person are mentioned as ashtau nindita in Ayurveda. This is hormonal imbalance. So the care must be taken. I am saying contraindication means you can give the fomentation, but very strict under crucial guidance and observation by the expert vaidya or the family doctor. Then it is allowed, not at all. Then another contraindication or safeguard, I can say, for the fomentation is a pregnancy period. Because pregnancy is nothing but the altered physiological but very delicate condition which may not tolerate the heat and hot treatments or even the behavior. So there we must take utmost precaution while giving any even soft fomentation to the pregnant lady. It should be the under guidance of expert vaidya. Then severe anemia and ascites are also contraindicated for fomentation. Excessive uncontrolled hypertension is a strong contraindication for Swedana. Otherwise, due to the vasodilatation effect of Swedana, patient may land into the brain hemorrhage or subarachnoid hemorrhage. So it is better to take the written consent of the patient even for Swedana, which patients are having hypertension or suffering from RHD, that is ischemic heart diseases. Written consent is better for the vaidya as well as for the patient. Now procedure for the Swedana Karma. Proper examination of the patient, especially to check whether the person is having pitta or the pitta vata prakriti. Proper history of the diseases like uncontrolled hypertension, bleeding disorders like idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura, ITP, or any bleeding or coagulation problems like thalassemia or the hemophilia. We must rule out these cases. Whether the patient is taking any anticoagulants, like for example aspirin in the patients of heart problem, in the patients if you are taking the warfarin for varicosity or deep vein thrombosis. Before Swedana Karma, it is better to do the bleeding time, clotting time and prothrombin time of the patient whenever it is indicated. If necessary, better take the written consent from the patient. Now, if we want to give the fomentation, better we give the pre-treatment like oleation or abhyanga. Only the exception is the cases with ama or ama vata problem. There we can give the direct ruksha svedana or the dry fomentation. Next, we have to decide that which type of the fomentation we have to use or how much intensity we have to use for Swedana or fomentation. Then the fomentation is given until the proper fomentation symptoms appear on the patient. What are the symptoms of proper fomentation? Sweating, of course. Relief from the pain relief from the shivering, relief from the coldness. So sweat generation, relief from the pain, coldness is observed very immediately. Then gradually after 2-3 days or after repeated fomentation, the patient is relieved from the stiffness, heaviness of the body, heaviness of the organ, and the patient, their skin will get the softness, muscles will get the softness. Then there will be feeling of lightness and also a little bit warm in the body. But sometimes there may be problem of excessive fomentation. So what will happen if excessive swedan is given? In Ayurveda it is called as swedana ati yoga. Ati yoga is a hyper. Patient may get shock because of the excessive sweating, which is called as a hypovolemic shock. Then because of the lot of sweating, there may be dehydration. This particular pathology is very similar to the pathology which we found in sunstroke. In the summer season, some people can die because of this sunstroke. What happens in the sunstroke? There is a trauma to the thermal regulating center in the brain. Then this patient may require to admit in the intensive care unit for the management of shock. Sometimes because of the excessive fermentation, there may be burning of that particular part, or there may be burning of the whole body. Sometimes due to the vasodilatation, capillary vasodilatation, bleeding or oozing can occur. There may be palpitation, there may be fainting, there may be giddiness or the vertigo. So all these symptoms can occur due to the excessive fomentation. Due to the excessive fomentation, swedana atiyo, excessive sweating, excessive thirst. As the water is going out, the patient may feel thirsty. He will demand more water. Then there may be fever, hyperpyrexia or hyperthermia. Skin can become red and hot. Only the difference we have to understand, sunstroke is severe because even there will not get a sweating, because thermal regulating center has been damaged. So the patient is very hot, redness is there, but no sweating. This is more dangerous than getting a more sweating. So sunstroke of course is very severe, and this type of condition can happen after giving excessive fomentation. Then vomiting. So when you put the patient in steam box, there should be one attendant, one houseman, one registrar to take carefully pulse or BP, or looking towards the symptoms of the patient, whether he is getting giddiness, whether he is getting complaining of anything, then immediately you stop the fomentation. What to do for the excessive fomentation management? If the shock, naturally admit in the hospital. IV fluids are necessary, like normal saline or dextrose normal saline. Sometimes if it is a moderate, oral rehydration with electrolyte powder. Oral medicated water can be given, like shadango dakka mentioned in Ayurveda. This shadango dakka, udakka means water, is processed with the herbs like musta, parpata, ushira, chandana, that is sandalwood, and nagar. So these are the plants which can make the water very cooling effect. Then you can give the tender coconut water to the patient, and orally you must give minimum for 3-4 days tablet chandrakala ras, 3 tablets morning, 3 tablets afternoon, 3 tablets in the evening, with aloe vera gel, oral drinking for as a anupan, or the vehicle for this particular chandrakala ras. Post therapeutic schedule. After the fermentation, patient should stay in the room which is having not too much wind. He should have the physical and mental rest. He can take the rest for 6 to 8 hours, and then he can take a shower. But after fermentation, never immediately go to swim in the cold water. That is antagonistic action, and that can damage your essential body parts. Then take the nutritious light, easily digestible food like mung dal, green gram soup with thin rice or the khichdi. So once again, I would like to repeat the contents of the PPT video. We have already seen the contraindications, I am sorry once again, of the fomentation, procedure for swedan or fomentation, then symptoms after the proper fomentation, symptoms after excessive fomentation, and how to manage those excessive fomentation. So once again, thank you very much. By myself, Dr. Professor Deshpande, I would like to have sharing of this video to your friends, and please subscribe my YouTube channel, which will definitely step by step, slow and steadily, will give the lot of very good information which you can adopt in your medical practice and in a very simplified and lucid language. Thanks for your nice cooperation. Take care. All the best. Thank you.